Well, initially you were interested in sculpture only?
No, initially I had no idea about sculpture, one subject is existing.
Okay.
Because I had no idea and I never tried also, I never touched clay or anything. And the artists who were practicing in Hyderabad also, with whom I was in touch, they were all painters or printmakers. So only once I moved to Baroda, when they conducted an examination to take students, where Subramanyam and others said, you are good in sculpture, your handling clay is very good, why don't you take up sculpture?
Okay.
But I didn't take it seriously. But that time, you are not admitted directly into specialization during my time.
It was a general.
General for 2 years, then you choose. So in the period of 2 years, then I developed a liking for sculpture. And maybe because I was not very good in perspective drawing, you know.
Okay.
Like showing perspective and painting and things. So I developed this, interest to work in clay and do three-dimensional objects where perspective is not involved. So I got involved more with the volume, surfaces, interested. And during that time, I got in touch with Professor Krishna Chatpar, under whose guidance I developed more keen interest in the sculpture.
So it means that you started working in that medium around which year?
75. Yeah, 77 onwards, full time.
Okay. And then you went to England after you got scholarship.
Yeah, yeah, that was in 1982.
So before going to England, what was your idea of Indian sculpture scene, modern Indian sculpture scene?
No, in 1980-81 onwards only, because of reading history and exposure to artistry and also a little bit traveling and seeing, started having some distinct vague idea of what it should be like, you know, the sculptures. Because during in 80s and after 75, I attended during that time between my college days, Trinale and all this. Whatever exhibitions used to take place, I and with my other friends, either come to Delhi and to see the exhibitions or go to Bombay. Or sometimes my professors were putting up exhibitions, so we used to go to help them.
So at that time, who inspired you most? Mostly Ram Kinkar was a great inspiration for many sculptors those days.
Yeah, of course, Ram Kinkar, I used to admire his work. But in general, I was looking at our own indigenous art and craft and our Indian sculpture in general, especially ancient sculpture like Mathura, Gupta and South Indian Vijayanagara period sculptures, because I was reading a lot about Stella Cambridge writings in Zimmer, and so their exposure helped me to have more deeper understanding about sculpture.
So it means that you were not interested in modern sculpture those days.
No, I was interested trying to do modern sculpture, but why modern, which people are not related much. If you see, during those days, either everybody was working under Henry Moore's British sculptor's influence or French sculptors. And even if somebody who was working like Bengal school artists or from Lucknow school and things, but I've seen mostly they are like a derivative and very stylized working. So which I didn't like, there was no spirit in the form or this. It's all like a very, in the sense they are like very, I cannot say exact what word, but they did not impress me.
Because in the 70s, I think Henry Moore was a kind of a very great name in Western sculpture. So Indian sculpture, they thought Henry Moore is our ideal.
See, what happened is basically in art schools, most of the art schools, because of scholarships was given by the French or the British or a couple of them by Italian. So these professors went there, got exposed to that, and they came and they taught us. And everybody was, that time this communication method all was not there. Whatever they got exposed, they thought that's the great thing. They came and tried to teach those. And naturally, in those days, you are very obedient students. So whatever professor says, you take it for granted. Those are the golden words, you know. You cannot go beyond. But at the same time, I felt, because of my readings and the professors who guided me, they said, we must look at our own roots, our own identity we must establish, we should, rather than something. And during those days, I have seen many of the sculptures produced. People were talking about surface qualities, you know. Like, people are not looking at actual sculpture intent, what artist is. Everybody, even in the newspapers or art, see, it is very well finished, smooth surface, and nice pink marble or black marble, or texture is good, kind of things. So there is no talk beyond that about the sculpture. So I said, is this is what the sculpture? It should be something more than that. Why people are just limiting about it? You know? And also people were working either in a stone or wood, or very few welded sculpture. You know? And most of those sculptures, modern sculptures, abstracts have produced, general public were not able to relate. I said, when you are producing for your own people, and most of them are not relating to it, what is the purpose? It's not just a decorative piece. It has to be beyond that.